So the Congress has once again come out to slam Rajinikanth for his comments on Periyar. The Tamil Nadu Congress chief Alagiri has questioned Rajinikanth's silence on the Babri demolition. KS Alagiri has said, will Rajinikanth explain the communal intention behind not speaking out about the happenings of 1992 and 1996? In fact, you've got KS Alagiri also saying that Rajinikanth is free to hold any opinion but should not fall prey to the hands of communal forces. Taking this once again across to Shalini Lobo. Shalini, this controversy is now escalating because you've got the Congress now jumping in, questioning Rajinikanth and saying, why is he being selective over his outrage?
Indeed, Akshita, you know, this is a statement released by the Tamil Nadu Congress Committee President KS Alagiri questioning Rajinikanth as to why he did not speak about events that took place between 1992 and 1996. Why is it that he was quiet on what happened in Ayodhya, the demolition of the Babri Masjid in 1992, and spoke about something in 1971 about Periyar, who is no longer alive? And he's also gone on to say that it's probably because Rajinikanth is falling prey to the communal forces in the country right now. KS Alagiri did put his opinion out on Twitter yesterday as well. And today in the morning, you had Congress MP Karthi Chidambaram also speak to the media, where he questioned Rajinikanth, asking him why is he silent on several issues, such as the Kashmir issue that happened in the state. Why is he silent on the violence in JNU? Why is he silent on CAA? Why was he silent on GST? But he's coming out and speaking on Periyar. Why is he silent on pertinent issues? The Congress also slammed Rajinikanth, and right now what's happening is only Rajinikanth seems to have political backing of the BJP in the state, with all the Dravidian parties and the Tamil Nadu Congress against him.
Okay, Shalini, thanks for joining us with all the details on that story.